So I'm playing this test disc in HDR on this Skyglass TV, and I'm going to put up a peak white test pattern. And to my eyes, and maybe to your eyes as well, this white actually looks quite dim for an HDR test pattern. And the reason is because of a picture setting on the Skyglass TV. So if we go into the picture settings submenu, click on picture and sound, and then click on picture, you need to turn off auto backlight adjustment to unlock the highest peak brightness that this TV is capable of. But besides that, even after you turn it off, the auto backlight adjustment is still in effect. You need to actually go into the backlight slider, and then you can see here that it is still quite dim. But even though I decrease the backlight by one click, you can see that the test pattern brightened up, which means that, you know, you need to manually adjust the backlight slider at least by one click before you will override the automatic backlight adjustment. And after that, we get out from the settings and click on currently playing. You can see that the test pattern is being displayed at the highest peak brightness that this TV is capable of, thus allowing for the best HDR picture quality. What I'm going to do now is instead for you to look at a really bright test pattern, I'm going to pull up Sky Sports News HD using the voice control. Hello Sky, play Sky Sports News HD. And then I'm going to pause it here, and then I'm going to show you the effects of various picture settings on this TV. If I get into the settings submenu again, click on picture and sound, go into picture, and because this is in SDR, the backlight has gone back down to 50, and that is acceptable. This will be around 200 nits, I think. And if we go into the viewing mode, I will show you the various picture presets that are available on the Skyglass TV. Auto is the default out-of-the-box picture preset. And then you get entertainment, you get sports. Sports is bluer in terms of the color temperature. Movie is the most accurate in terms of the D65 white point. And then with music, party, and then with custom. The way Sky has configured this television is that if you get out from here, and let's say if you go into picture and you adjust any of the custom picture settings, it will populate the custom picture mode. So for example, we are currently in auto picture mode, and I'll show you that we are actually in auto picture mode. In fact, I'll change it to the most accurate movie picture mode, okay? So we are in movie mode, and if we go into the picture submenu, click on custom settings, there are various parameters that we can adjust. Let's say we decide to adjust sharpness down to 49. And if we get out from here and go in again, you can see that the viewing mode is now custom. This means that any of the custom settings that you adjust will populate the custom picture mode. So in effect, there is only one adjustable picture preset on this TV. And I will explain all these settings. So contrast will determine the digital white level. If you drop it too low, then you will be losing dynamic range. But if you go too high, then you may be clipping some near white detail. And I'll just go back to the default value of 49 for SDR. Sharpness will apply some edge enhancement. And in my opinion, this is unnecessary because it will exaggerate the film grain and also the noise in the picture. I would normally just go for a sharpness of 0, which is neutral and doesn't add edge enhancement, and it will reduce the noise and also cause the picture to look more natural rather than artificial. And then with video brightness, this will affect the digital black level. If you increase video brightness by too much, this will just wash out the picture because you are elevating the black level unnecessarily without any increase in shadow detail. But if you drop it too low, then you will be crushing some shadow detail. If you look on her sweater, you know, it will just lose all the detail. If you drop video brightness too low, I advise you to just stick to the default value of 50. And then with color saturation, this will increase the saturation and also the luminance of all the colors. So you can see here that if you increase it, you know, everything looks luminous and her skin tones look really, you know, ruddy. But if you drop it too low, then you'll be desaturating all the color. Again, I think Sky has tuned their TV quite nicely, so I think a color saturation of 50 is correct. I still need to put a meter on this TV, but superficially to my eyes, subjectively, it looks quite accurate out of the box in the movie picture preset. Hue will rotate all the colors, and then, you know, it will turn red or green one way or the other. And again, 50 is the default value, and I would advise you to stick with it unless you have an advanced meter to play with all these different settings. And under white balance, this allows you to calibrate the grayscale. There are several color temperature picture presets. Standard D65 looks the most accurate to my eyes. Warm is a bit reddish, whereas cool is bluer. And again, if you adjust any of these 2-point white balance controls, so I'll explain what red gain is. Red gain, green gain, and blue gain are offset stands for red offset, G offset stands for green offset, and blue offset stands for blue offset. So these are basically 2-point white balance controls to let you calibrate the grayscale as well as this TV can allow. And the gain controls will affect the brighter portion of the grayscale, whereas the offset controls will affect the darker portion of the grayscale. And let's say if I am in D65 and, you know, I think it is not accurate and I use a meter to adjust it. Let's say if I actually decrease red gain by 1 and then it will populate the custom 2-point, which means that, you know, again, you only have one adjustable white balance system. So I would advise you not to play with this unless, you know, you have a meter. I would advise you to just go with the standard D65 color temperature preset, which should give you a very good base for accurate colors and grayscale from this television. This TV is meant to be equipped with local dimming, but when I turned it on and off, I can't really see any difference in picture quality, so I will need to investigate further. And there are no different levels of local dimming intensity that you can select. It is basically only an on-off toggle. And under color space management, there are the three primary colors of red, green, and blue, and the three secondary colors of yellow, cyan, and magenta. And under each color, there are three further parameters that you can adjust: hue, which will rotate the tint, saturation, which will increase or decrease the saturation, and luminance, which will affect the brightness of the color. So this is essentially an HSL color management system, or CMS. Again, I strongly advise you not to touch this unless you have a colorimeter or some sort of equipment to measure the colors on your TV and make adjustments in a competent manner. And outside of here, I think, you know, you video enthusiasts out there may have noticed that there is actually no gamma control, so you can't adapt the gamma or transfer function of this TV according to the lighting conditions. Backlight will affect the light output of this TV. So let's say if you increase the backlight to 100, you know, it will just increase the brightness overall. And then if you decrease the backlight, this will dim down the whole picture. So I will leave it to be around 50 in SDR, which is around 200 plus nits. And this TV also supports Dolby Vision, and there are two picture modes here that you can use. You can use the more accurate dark picture mode, or if you are one of those who are perverse enough to watch Dolby Vision content in a bright room, you can go for the bright picture mode in terms of Dolby Vision, but know that it will not be as accurate as the Dolby Vision dark picture mode. And I think aspect ratio is probably an important one for many people as well. I think, you know, because the Sky platform is inside the TV itself, so in theory, overscan should always be disabled. But if you are using another external device that is sending 1080i to the TV, you should use feed to screen, which will disable overscan and allow you to get the sharpest picture without H enhancement because of 1/1 pixel mapping, or you know, as close to natively scaled as possible. And default streaming format, again, depending on your internet connection that you have hooked up to this TV, you can go for UHD or HD, and UHD is necessary to unlock some of the HLG content. Again, I will need to test all this when I get around to reviewing this TV. I think that concludes my walkthrough of the picture settings on this TV. So there are three things that you need to do, in my opinion, to get the best picture quality from this TV. You need to turn off automatic backlight adjustment. And besides doing that, you need to actually just manually adjust the backlight by one click and then go back up to make the manual backlight adjustment take effect. And secondly, I would strongly advise you to use the movie mode. But if you use the movie mode and then, you know, you still need to go into the custom settings to decrease sharpness all the way to zero, which will make it a custom picture mode. To watch my first impressions of the Sky Glass TV, please click here for my coverage video at the launch event.